बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम क्लास। टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस एंड लर्न अबाउट द पेरेंटल केयर इन फिशेज, इन विच वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पेरेंटल केयर बिफोर हैचिंग एंड पेरेंटल केयर आफ्टर हैचिंग इन मैनी ग्रुप्स ऑफ फिशेज। नाउ इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द पेरेंटल केयर इन फिशेज, पेरेंटल केयर इज एनी बिहेवियर पैटर्न in which a parent invests time or energy in feeding and protecting its offsprings. Parental care is a form of altruism, since this type of behavior involves increasing the fitness of the offsprings at the expense of the parents. The evolution of parental care is beneficial as it facilitates offsprings' performance traits that are ultimately tied to offsprings' fitness. And because parental care is evolved in those organisms which produce limited number of eggs to ensure the continuity of their race. Now if we talk about the parental care, it also offers some advantages as it helps in the survival of the offsprings. It also provides protection and it contributes to the reproductive fitness of the offsprings, as well as increased growth rate and quality, and it is also involved in better development of the offsprings. In case of fishes, there are two types of parental care, that is number one, as I have shown you in this slide, that care before hatching. In many fishes, care of embryos is limited or absent, like 77% of fishes shows no parental care. But 17% of fishes shows or care for eggs only, and 6% care for egg and newly hatched young ones. Fishes shows parental care in many ways, like some fishes construct nest and some carry embryo during their development. Brooding in special pouches, some fishes as clusters of brood their cluster of embryos in special pouches which are attached to some part of their body. Examples include sea horses and pipe fishes, in which the males of these fishes carry embryos in ventral pouches. And brooding in mouth. Some fishes exhibit brooding in their mouth, and the examples of these fishes include male Brazilian catfish and male banded jawfish. In case of male Brazilian catfish, broods embryos in an enlarged lower lip. They brood their embryos in an enlarged lower lip. But in case of male banded jawfish, they orally brood their eggs, and the male retrieves the female eggs and brood them until they hatch. During brief period, when the jawfish is feeding, the eggs are left in the burrow. In this slide, you may see the seahorse and pipe fishes. Seahorse is the name given to 45 species of small marine fish in the genus Hippocampus. Hippocampus comes from the ancient Greek Hippocampus, itself from hippos meaning horse and campos meaning sea monster. Having a head and neck suggestive of a horse, seahorses also feature segmented bony armor, an upright posture and a curled prehensile tail. The male seahorse is equipped with a pouch on the ventral or front-facing side of the tail. When mating, the female seahorse deposits up to 1500 eggs in the male's pouch. The male carries the eggs for 9 to 45 days until the seahorse emerges fully developed, but very small. The young are then released into the water, and the male often mates again within hours or days during the breeding season. You may see the great pipefish. The great pipefish has a long segmented armored body, angular in cross section and stretching up to 45 cm long. With its stiff appearance, it ranges a color brown to green in with broad alternating light and dark hue along it. It customized by a long snout with mouth on end and a slight hump on the top of the body just behind the eyes. And the fish is generally 33 cm to 35 cm in length. In this slide, you can see the image of a male seahorse. The male seahorse has a pouch on its stomach in which to carry babies, and it can carry almost 2000 at a time, and its pregnancy varies from species to species. The reproductive process begins when a male and a female seahorse do daily pre-dawn dances, intertwining their tails and swimming together. Eventually, they engage in a true courtship dance, which can last as long as 8 hours. It ends with the female depositing her eggs in the male's pouch. In this slide, you may see the brood pouch of male pipefish. Male pipefish Cygnathus and its brood pouch is shown dissected and open to show eggs. You may see the eggs of a male brood pouch. And males of the brood broad-nosed pipefish care for the offsprings by brooding embryos in a brood pouch. Brooding males can absorb nutrients that emanate from embryos, and there is often a reduction in offspring's number over the brooding period. This slide is also showing the brood pouch of pipefishes, in which placenta-like tissue is present on the dorsal side and a brood pouch is present on the ventral side, in which various eggs are present. And in the C diagram, you may see the capillary and epithelial villi and apical pore as well as the eggs. In the previous slides, we have discussed about male pipefishes as well as the seahorses, which provides parental care before hatching. Now we will discuss about the parental care after hatching, which is exhibited by some species of fishes like sunfishes and sticklebacks, and they provide short-term care after hatching of the young. And this short-term care is provided by the males of these fishes. As they collect fresh plant material into a mass, and the young lives in this mass of leaves. Sometimes young moves away from the nest, then the male bring it in its mouth and spit it back into the nest. In this slide, you may see the sticklebacks, which provide a short-term care after hatching. And these sticklebacks are carnivorous, and they feed on small animals such as insects, crustacean and fish larvae, and sticklebacks are most commonly found in the ocean. All stickleback species show similar unusual mating behavior. The male develop a red breast and construct a nest from weeds held together by secretions from their kidneys, then attract females to the nest. A female lays her eggs inside the nest, where the male fertilizes them. The male then guards the eggs until they hatch, and may continue to guard the fry after they hatch. This large investment in both the nesting site and guarding of the eggs limits the number of females a male can mate with. This introduces the ability for selection to favor male mate choice. Some males die following spawning. In this slide, you may see the nest built by male sticklebacks. As I already have told you that the male develops a red breast and they construct a nest from weeds held together by secretions from their kidneys, and then they attract females to the nest. Now in this slide, you may see the image of a sunfish. Sunfishes are a family of freshwater ray-finned fish belonging to the order Perciformes, and they also provide short-term care to their offsprings. To initiate the process of reproduction, male dig a deep circular depression in the substrate with their caudal fins to create a nest, which they will aggressively defend from intruding males. Male and females then undergo a courtship dancing ritual before the female deposits her eggs into the male's nest. Multiple females may deposit eggs in a single nest. Larger males usually attract more mates and also takes better care of their offsprings. Male parental care includes nest building, nest gardening, guarding of eggs and fry, and nest fanning, which means aerating the eggs. Now in this slide, you can see the northern sunfish, which is guarding his nest.
Now we will discuss about the long-term care which is provided by Cichlidae. And Cichlidae is the family of fishes which comprises more than 1300 species of fishes in the order of Perciforms, and many of which are popular aquarium fishes. Cichlids are primarily freshwater fishes and are found in tropical America, mainland Africa and Madagascar, and southern Asia. The majority of species are African, appearing in great diversity in the major African lakes. These species usually do not grow more than 30 cm in length, and these fishes show different adaptations for long-term care, like the young ones are brooded in mouth in some species, while in others the species tend or rear their young ones in a nest. After hatching, the young comes out from parent's mouth or nest. The parent signals danger with flicking of pelvic fins, so the young returns quickly to the mouth or the nest. This slide is showing the image of a cichlid fish. In this slide, you may see the mouth brooding cichlid fish. And mouth brooding, which is also known as oral incubation and buccal incubation, is the care given by some groups of animals to their offsprings by holding them in the mouth of the parent for extended periods of time. Although mouth brooding is performed by a variety of different animals such as Darwin's frog, fishes are by far the most diverse mouth brooders. In case of maternal mouth brooders, the female takes the eggs. Maternal mouth brooders are found among both African and South American cichlids. In this case, typically after courtship, the male fertilizes the eggs and then collects them in his mouth, holding on to them until they hatch. During this time, he cannot feed. Among the maternal mouth brooding cichlids, it is quite common for the male to fertilize the eggs only once they are in the female mouth. Some cichlids are able to feed while mouth brooding the eggs, but invariably they feed less often than they would otherwise do, and after mouth brooding one batch of eggs, all mouth brooding fish are underweight and require a period of time to feed and make up for the depletion of their energy reserves. In this slide you can see the nest of a cichlid fish. And in all the cases, the eggs are protected until they hatch and the fry becomes free swimming. Only in some cases does the parent extend protection to mobile juveniles. Among the cichlids and arowanas, extension of brood care to fry is common, and they have behavioral cues to tell fry swimming and feeding away from the parent that danger is approaching and that they should return to their parent's mouth. By caring for their offspring in this way, mouth brooding fish are able to produce smaller number of offsprings with a higher chance of survival than species that offer no brood care.